What is up YouTube, how's it going? I'm Sparsh and welcome to another tutorial video. Now in this one, we're gonna talk about browser automation with the help of Selenium. So Selenium is a Python module which helps us to automate browsers. Now if you go to the Selenium documentation, you'll find that Selenium is an umbrella project for a range of tools and libraries that enable and support the automation of web browsers. Now in this video, I'm going to give a very brief introduction to Selenium. We're going to look at some basic commands. This is just to give you a very basic understanding of Selenium module and how it does what it does. So first of all, to get started, we need to install Selenium on our machine. To do that, there are multiple ways to install Selenium. For one, you can go to your command prompt if you're on Windows, or if you're on Mac, you can go to the terminal and just write pip install Selenium, and it should install Selenium on your machine. Now as you can see, I'm using PyCharm here. So if you're on PyCharm and you need to install Selenium, you just go to the terminal and write pip install Selenium. This command should install Selenium on your computer. Now you can see my requirements already satisfied because I have already installed. Now if this doesn't work for you, somehow you can go to the file settings, project Python interpreter, and you hit the you can see different libraries and frameworks installed here. You can go to the plus and you can just search for Selenium here, and you should select it and install package. It should install it. Now after that, we're gonna have to download a web driver also. Selenium requires a web driver to work with the respective web browser. Now I have one already installed, but I'm gonna show you how you can download the web driver for your corresponding web browsers. Now you go to the Google Chrome and you search selenium.dev, which is the official site of Selenium. You go to the downloads tab and you scroll all the way down to the third party drivers, bindings and plugins. Now in this you can see the browsers tab, and under this you will find different browsers like Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, Opera. Now if you are on Firefox, you will go to the documentation under the Firefox heading. If you are on Safari, you will go to the corresponding documentation. I'm on Chrome, so I will go to the documentation under the Chrome section, and this should open if you're using Chrome. And if you want to automate the Chrome browser, this should open. Now all versions available in downloads are latest stable release Chrome driver 81. You should just hit this link and it should bring you to this page where there are different versions of Chrome driver. If you are on a Linux, you should download Chrome driver Linux. If you're on Mac, you should download this file, but if you're on Windows, you should just click on it. And I have already installed this. Now you will get a zip file. Let me go to my download section. You will get something like this. You will extract it. Now I have Chrome driver sitting here on my E drive. This is important. You need to know where your Chrome driver is extracted, because we're gonna need the path. Now back to Python, PyCharm. Now this Selenium module is gonna be, we're gonna do all of this in the Python console. So you should be able to do this in Python shell as well. So after opening the Python console, we need to import Selenium. From Selenium, we need to import WebDriver. Now I am considering here that you have Selenium installed, and if in case Selenium isn't installed on your machine, Stack Overflow is your best friend. Now after importing WebDriver from Selenium, we're gonna have to create a browser object. This is just a variable, you can name it whatever you want. So browser equals to webdriver.chrome, which is our browser which we want to automate. Now as I have said, this is important to know where your Chrome driver is on your PC. My Chrome driver is in the E drive, so I'll just go E colon double backslash and the name of my file .exe. And inside these double quotes, you will have to provide the full path of your driver. So you hit enter. Now this should open a new Google tab, and you can see Chrome is being controlled by automated test software written here. Now we have successfully able to open the Google Chrome by just writing a simple command here. Now let's just open a URL or any website by the get method. Inside the parentheses, you will specify the name of the website you want to open. So let's go and open amazon.com. Now you need to put in the whole URL here. So from the beginning, http://amazon.com, hit enter, and as you can see, amazon.com is opened in our web browser. Now let me just put these two side by side so you can see what is happening while we are running our script. Let me just I did okay. No, it isn't. Let's give it a second. Okay. Let me just put this aside. And here we go. Okay. So we have successfully opened a website by just writing a command browser.get. Now we can click on any of these navigations here by just inputting the text. So the command for that will be browser dot these are all elements of this HTML page. So you can just go, you can just find element by simple link text. Now let's go and click on this today's deals button. Now in this field, you're gonna have to write full name of the button you want to open or the link you want to open. Now you can see it has provided us with this weird link. So let's just make it easy and put this link in an element. So the link to this button is now in the element variable. So now if you go element dot, you can see that there are various type of method that we can access. Like we can access text, which will return us the text of this button, and also there is we can also get attribute. We can also get to the link of this button by passing the href string reference, which is short for hyper reference. So you can see it has provided the link for this button. Now we can also enter text in this text box by this Python script alone. For that, we need to find this the ID of this text box. Now when HTML page is created, every element is uniquely given an ID to uniquely identify that. So if you right click on this text box and go to the inspect section, and you do that again, and you can see the ID is two tab search text box. So you will copy this. We just want the ID because from the methods we will select find element by ID. I'll put it back here. So let's do element dot find element by ID, and inside this double quotes we will put the ID name. It will be browser dot find element. You know, this is the attribute of the browser. Now we will put in again in the element variable. Now element variable contains the ID of this text box. So we can write on this text box by the method send keys. Now inside this send keys, we can enter anything that we want to search, we want to put in the text box. So since we are on Amazon, let's type in MacBook Pro. As you can see, MacBook Pro has been entered in this text box as soon as we entered this script. Now, to simulate the enter key or automate our browser to hit the enter key after we put in the text, we're gonna have to import something else too. So after inputting the text, if we wish to enter, hit enter, we need to import from Selenium dot webdriver dot common dot keys import keys with capital K. Now we can go to the method element dot send keys, and inside these parentheses, instead of the string, we will write keys dot enter. And as soon as we press enter, you can see in this browser, with the help of this script, we have entered, hit enter, and the search is displayed on the web browser. So yeah, you can do a bunch of stuff with Selenium. It's a very powerful tool. Now that's it. It's just the basic brief introduction to Selenium module. It helps us to automate web browsers. So with this, I can write Python scripts to do a whole bunch of stuff on browsers like web scraping, fill out forms, etc. So we did some pretty fascinating things in this video. We learned how to click on elements, how to find elements by link text or by IDs, how to fill or populate the text field, and also how to hit the enter key after we put in the text field. So that's it. I know you can go to the Google and find different kinds of methods or attributes and try it yourself. So that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Signing off.